Computing variability in SPSS will be much easier than computing it by hand. Here in Excel, you can see that I have the same adults and teens data from the like-like.xlsx workbook. Remember that we entered our data into sheet 1 and then copied and pasted them into sheet 2. This way, the original data will still be on our sheet 1 without additional calculations. When you plan to import data from Excel to SPSS, do two things. Number one, put simple variable names in the top row. And number two, put your cleaned data on sheet 1. You should now save this workbook, save it to your desktop, and close it in Excel. We will import this data into SPSS, then find the means and standard deviations for both adults and teens using the frequency menu. The like-like.xlsx workbook should be saved to your desktop. Close the workbook. This will not work if it is still open in Excel. Now, open SPSS. I am now ready to import the like-like.xlsx dataset into SPSS. You'll notice that I have the workbook here on my desktop. Go to File, Open, Data. If you're not in the desktop, switch to the desktop, and you'll first notice that you don't see the file you're looking for. Change Files of Type to Excel. And now the Excel file is visible. Click on it and open. The dialog box that pops up asks us two important things. Should SPSS read the variable names from the first row of data? Yes, it should. We created those variable names in our first row of data for that reason. The second thing is, what sheet should SPSS read the data from? By default, it's sheet 1. We could choose sheet 2 or sheet 3, but we've put our cleaned data onto sheet 1, so there's nothing to change. The default settings are fine. Let's just click OK. We do want to do a little bit of cleaning first. Go to Variable View, and we'll set both of these measures to scale. Now we'll go back to Data View. We don't really have to. We can also do an analysis from Variable View. But let's go to Analyze, Descriptive Statistics, and Frequencies. In our frequencies box, move both adults and teens into the variables box and click on statistics. We want the mean and the standard deviation, but let's also get the variance and the range. Click continue, OK, and there is our output. Let's look at this a little more closely. Here in the output, we can see that the teens used the word like approximately twice as often as the adults did, but that their standard deviations were similar, 2.1 versus 2.97. Use your calculator to compute the square root of the variance numbers to make sure that they match the standard deviation values. Check these values against what you calculated in Excel and make sure they match. Also remember that values calculated by hand may vary due to rounding. If you were off by a hundredth of a point, it's probably a rounding error.